Looks like we've got all the dependencies for Librsvg. So when it comes back, I just want to check. I'm pretty sure we did this one. GDK. X-Men. Perhaps we didn't. That's strange. So that Rusty was highlighted as if that's what I needed to install. I'm not sure why GDK Pixbuff is not installed. Clearly I need to install it. Oh, there it is there. So this needs to be moved to here. So glib kind of got libjpg turbo we've installed, libpng was already there, we've got that one. Oh, it's a runtime dependency, librsvg. Okay, so this is like a circular dependency, but only at runtime for librsvg. So that's okay. And we need to install libtiff. It needs freemake and freeglut. Recommended GLU. So again, we're getting involved in a big cycle here. So this looks like a good place to start. So GLU, there's no options here, so we just copy and paste the instructions as they are. Okay, it's built, so now we can install. That's done. So GLU's done, that's X library, chapter 25. That one down. Freeglut. That one's ready to go. Okay, it's in SourceForge. Okay, so we've got a couple of options here. Build demos off to disable the demo programs. But if you choose to build them, the installation must be done manually. So the installation is not recommended, and we've got an option to turn off static libraries. So really, oh, there's a patch which we've got to download. The first thing we need to do is to apply that patch. And then we can just copy and paste these instructions as they are. no test suite, so it just gets installed as it is. So Libtiff next. We've got libjpg turbo. We need libwebp. So got all these. Oh, Libtiff. Now that's interesting. All right. So libwebp is optional for Libtiff, but libwebp needs Libtiff. So what I'm going to have to do is to install Libtiff now. I'll install libwebp and then go back and install Libtiff while I'm here doing this. And I didn't mark off Freeglut, I just realised, which is also chapter 25. So let's download TIFF. And just copy and paste this as it is. Okay, that's done. Run the tests. Kind of wondered if it was worth running the test, but I thought, well, if I rebuild it, it'll be interesting to see if there's any changes in the tests. They've all passed as it is. There's 108 of them. So now, as the root user, install this package for the first time. That's done. There's nothing else to be done there. And I'm as a root, so let's come back out. Okay, now I'm going to move on to libwebp. So this has also got dependency of SDL. Right, so that's got lots of dependencies, so I'm going to just install this to get libwebp running, and this can be installed at a later point again, reinstalled. So save link as. So notice that was capital SDL. Don't think I'm going to use any of those switches unless I find that I need to. So I'm just going to copy and paste those commands. See how long this takes. 0.6 SPU. Okay, and now we need to install it. That's done. Now it says about testing. I'm not going to bother with this because there's a lot of things like the house is not, there's no libraries. There's chances are some things won't work. I think there's lots of dependencies missing. So I won't bother with that. But we'll just mark that off in chapter 42 to reload it. So it's SDL, not SDL2. And I'll shut that down for now. Go back to LibWebp, also tidy up. And move on to the next package, which is giflib. So we've got the requirement for this. Save link as. Oh, SourceForge is it again? So extract this giflib and we run make to build it. And then install it with these commands. It's done. So that's chapter 10. Flip. So back to LibWebP now. We've got all the dependencies installed. Save the package. What's it called? LibWebP. In there to enable or disable. Just copy and paste this. Okay, and finally installed it. So that's LibWebP done. And that's chapter 10 as well. LibWebP. So now I'm going to reinstall Libtiff because we've now got all the dependencies installed. So once again, just copy and paste these commands. That's interesting, did that say? thought. Let me just stop that a moment. Glut, I thought we'd installed that. All right, it's found glut, GL glut header is found. Okay. That's okay. I'll just let that carry on now. So test it again, same number of tests, all passed again. So now reinstall it. And that's done now. So libtiff is chapter 10 again. It's actually called tiff. Well, they've called it libtiff in the book, but the package is called tiff. So shut that down. Now we'll go back to GDK pixbuff. So we should have all the packages installed. As I said, Librsvg is a runtime dependency, so we don't need to have that installed now, so that's okay, but we're going to install it in a moment after we've installed this one. So have we got anything to add here? No. So we'll just copy and paste these instructions. You can see it's enabled the libraries that we've installed, PNG, JPEG, TIFF. So that's good. Right, so that's built. I'm going to run the test. It says it makes heavy use of disks, so if you're still on a mechanical disk, it's likely that these tests will take a lot longer. So that's completed. Right, we've got the error with this character set, but apart from that, there's an OK for everything that has tested, so I'm going to install the package now. What am I doing? SU. That's better. So that's built. GDK pixbuff is chapter 25. Cross that off as complete. Shut it down, tidy up, and move on to Librsvg. So we should have all the dependencies for this installed now. Yep, I think this is ready. I don't remember if I've downloaded this, not that I haven't. So save link as. Looks like that's a slightly bigger package. Just see if there's anything else I've just installed that needs to be removed from here. Doesn't look like it. Okay, So installation. So enable GTK doc for the API documentation. So apart from that, it looks like this default is fine for what we've got installed. So that's built, so I'm going to install it. Now I'm going to run the tests, as it says there, that it's not recommended. So just go straight for the install. It's finished, there's no configuration, and I think that's completed. Just thinking, did I mark this one off? Oh, yes, I think I did. Check 25. Pixbuff. Yes, I did. It's Pixbuff. Xlib, but I didn't. We haven't done yet, sorry. So that's okay. So this one's in chapter 10. LibRSGV. Okay, so that's complete now. So I'll get rid of that tab and tidy up. So go back to GTK3. Now can't see LibRSGV there, so I'm not sure what. Well, this was installed, it's obviously moved, I've moved a tab somewhere, so what I'm going to do is to go through these tabs just to identify what we've got. So, I guess that could install, depends on ICU really, I think, which is one thing I want to install. That's up here, is LLVM again. That would work all right, actually. LLVM needs CMake, yeah. Go back around to here. What else does LLVM need? Nothing from the looks of it. CMake. Oh, yeah, that needs Git and Q. Oh, was it Subversion, was it? Does that need Surf? I think I did that one. Yeah, this is downloaded. Alright, it's here, so maybe I haven't done it yet. So libsecret. Where was that? Okay, libsecret. GCR's needed. Oh, GCR needed GTK Plus. That's right. So I don't know why I needed that. LibRSGV now. SVG. Oh, was it Glib? I bet it's Glib. It's not such a big deal because I'm sure there's going to be something else that needs LibRSVG. GPS requires that. I think I could probably do that JS. This one I can do. This is requiring Glib to be reinstalled in G settings. Yeah, I kind of got lost here again. Working. one, got that, that one, desktops. So this one could be built, G settings, desktop, oh, that's what this one is. Glib and object introspection. Maybe that's the way to go, then let's do this one next, and then glib networking. So let's see if we've got this. Right, so let's save this as so there's no extra options specified, so let's just build it as it is, and there's no test suite, so when it's built we can do sudo ninja install and that's done. So that's on to chapter 33. So the GNOME chapter is all out of order, but it's at the top, that one, G settings, desktop schemas. Yeah, so move that one out. Glib networking. There's glib, which we're going to reinstall. It did say it was a circular dependency. GLUTLS, yep, so this one can be downloaded now. So we've got this package. Again, it's a simple installation. So let's run the tests. And we've got our usual failure. But all the tests have run, so that's fine. Install it. And that's done. And that's in chapter 17. Glib networking. To glib, so got to glib networking sysprof. Let's see if that was. No, looks like we need to have a look at that one. There's a load of oh, yes, there is. So that one's going to be a reinstall sysprof. I've got that one. Shared my info. Yeah, we've done that one. So it's desktop file utils we need. Optional Emacs. Not interested in Emacs, so I'll just save this link. File utils and extract it. If upgrading from a previous version, so not, so don't need to look at that. So we just move on to the build. That's done as in the test suite, so just install it. And that's complete. So that's chapter 11. Desktop file. Utils. That's complete. So glib has just got system. We want to build it again. Let's have another look at this. Oh, this is one that needed GTK 3 plus. GTK 3 plus has got quite a few dependencies. Yeah, the requirements as well. So that one can be installed. That one needs GTK plus, so there's a circular dependency there. As a circular dependency. Oh, sorry, this is... Oh, right, this is for a sysprof, so... So GTK3 needs to be, definitely needs to be installed before this. And I think we've got those two. So they're easy. GTK3 is just a bit of a pain to do. Let's have a quick look at these then. Okay, yeah, we're getting buried again. Right, I think I will build glib without sysprof and just mark it down that needs to be reinstalled after sysprof. Because otherwise we're getting too deep, so I'll get rid of that. I'm going to build glib now. And in fact, I'm going to make a note now in case I forget. Against glib, so it needs a third installation after sysprof. And that'll help unlock a lot more stuff. So, just quickly check we've got all the other stuff yet. Patch, this allows you to set the warnings level. Previous version is installed, so we haven't got a previous version, it's the same version. Move the headers out of the way so that later packages do not encounter conflicts. So that's mentioning glib 2.0. Let's just have a look. Sorry, user include glib. Oh, it has. Yeah, I wonder if we should do this now, thinking about it. might be safest too. So that's done that. Build this with man is true to build the manual pages, we want that. GTK doc to build the API documentation, don't need that, so we'll just accept the default build instructions. So we've got libxslt installed, so if we see these errors, it says when generating the man pages they're harmless, so we can ignore them, about 33 errors. Okay, it says here that there's a secondary dependency with desktop file utils to do the test. So we've got that installed now because we already had built glib. So I'll just wait for that to finish now. So there's those errors that are mentioned at the end of the build there, so obviously nothing to worry about. Oops. Keep forgetting the focus is with the mouse. So change over here, become the root. Install. And let's come out of root, run ninja test. Otherwise it says one will fail if it's run as root. Right, so that's finished testing. I think everything went through okay. I'm just going to scroll back to see if I can see anything that didn't say okay. And it certainly looks, yep, that looks okay. All the tests have passed. So, that should be it. It just says to, it mentions about this file here, it's a reinstall from an earlier version. In theory, shouldn't need to do this. I'm just going to have a quick spy at that. It doesn't exist, so obviously it doesn't need to be removed, which kind of makes sense with what's written there. So that package has been reinstalled. I've got a note saying that I want to reinstall it once more after the sysprof, I think it is, has been installed. So I'll get rid of that for now, and hopefully that'll unlock other stuff to some extent. So let's look for the next one. So that needs sysprof. Right, I haven't installed Polkit yet, and it seems to be popping up quite a few times. Oops. We'll just see if it is actually in the list. It's there. Right, that needs JS78. This JS78 is looking like it's gonna have to be installed. I see you. That needs that LLVM again. I'm wondering how well that's been installed now. Let's go through this again. It's got subversion. Secret. Glib. Got these. Known keyring. It's a runtime dependency. Dbus, GCR. GCR. So we've got P11 kit. I think GCR can be installed now. Although again it will need to be reinstalled after GTK3 is installed. But that allowed us to do GCR, which allows us to do Gnome keyring, allows us to do libsecret, which allows us to do subversion. Then there's maybe just that one there. Let's have a look at that. So that's a module with no dependencies, so that's good. Open that one up into a new tab. Java bindings. So we can do that. Won't be able to test the Java bindings without JUnit 4. I guess could probably put that on. Then having subversion helps with getting Git installed. So that would only need TK to be installed. So I think this is probably a way to go. Then we've got Mercurial, which needs docutils. I think that's been kicking around in the tab list somewhere. Doc, is it that one there, maybe? To build some documentation. Git, we will have installed. I think we've got that one installed. We've got that. Pigments is installed. Rusty is installed. Subversion will be installed. So that means that gets fulfilled. That means we can build curl, at least without Samba. I don't know how easy Samba would be. But it certainly gets rid of a few. So I think, yep, GCR with an option to rebuild after GTK has been rebuilt, after GTK has been built. So that is, I think, the next plan. Yeah, that's just got too many on it, I think, for now. Going to tack that another time.